Hi guys, today's tutorial is how to make this bunny bee. I have this guy in the shot because his tutorial is coming up next. And because this part of the bunny and this part of the bunny are the exact same, I actually saved myself a little bit of filming. And I filmed this part here once. So the beginning of the tutorial, you'll see white yarn. You of course are to use yellow to follow along with your bee. And we go from the magic circle all the way up to row 13 with white yarn. And then I come back with the yellow where the pattern starts to differ. And I do want to mention here, because we have these color changes that might throw some of you off from making him, but I actually go through every row. So at the end of every row where we switch colors, I walk you through it. So I'm hoping that some of you get your bunny bee made, even if you haven't crocheted that much before. So to make this guy, I used yellow and black worsted weight yarn and a 3.75 millimeter hook. And those two eyes in there are actual safety eyes, and they're 7.5 millimeter. And I used a little bit of felt for the ears and some hot glue to put the felt on. You can find the written pattern for this guy in the description box below, or go to my website, amigurumitogo.com. And look on the right-hand side of the page for a list of all my free patterns. So good luck and have fun, and if you do make a bunny, please stop by my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely, and post pictures. I would love to see them. Thanks for watching, and have fun! Okay, so we're going to start with a magic circle with 6 stitches in it. If you don't know how to do a magic circle, then click that link that's popping up on your screen. I have a tutorial that will walk you through the steps of making a magic circle. And when you have that, come on back and we're going to put 2 single crochets in every one of those 6 stitches. And here I'm going to do something different that I've never really shown in my tutorials before. You know this starting tail that you get when you make a magic circle? We can leave it hanging and just tuck it into our piece after our piece is made, or we can get rid of it right now by crocheting it into our stitches. If you're not comfortable with doing that, just leave it. It's fine hanging the way it is. It's just going to be in the way for you. So to make it easier, let's just crochet that right into our piece. So we're going to put 2 single crochets in the first stitch. There's 1 single crochet, and now we're going to go back in the same hole we were just in. And that's 2 single crochets. And keep holding this along the edge of your piece there. Next, then we're going to repeat that 5 more times. 1 single crochet, and then back in the same hole, 2 single crochets. And now we have 12 stitches around, and that tail is almost completely gone, and it's out of the way. So we're ready to start round 3, and here we're going to put in a marker, and we're going to take a piece of yarn of a different color, and just put it right in our last stitch that we just put in. And we're going to move that marker every time we're finished a row. Okay, so round 3 is going to be 1 single crochet in the first stitch, 2 single crochets into the second, then we're going to repeat that sequence until we land on our marker. Let's do that together here, and we're still going to bury this tail. There's 1, and then we're going to go into the next stitch and put 2 single crochets. Now we're going to repeat that, 1 single crochet, and then 2, and then 1 after that. Now we're going to repeat that, 1 single crochet into the first stitch, and then 2 single crochets into the second. And we're going to land on our marker when we're done. So I'm just going to finish off the last set of my sequence. I'm going to put 1 single crochet, and then the next stitch we're going to put 2 single crochets, and notice I'm landing right on the marker, so we can take that marker out and put 2 single crochets. There was 1, and back in the same hole we're just in for 2. And then we're finished row 3, and now we have 18 stitches around. We're going to move our marker, and we're going to put it right in that last stitch we just put in. And we're going to start round 4. Put 1 single crochet in the first stitch, 1 single crochet into the second, and then two single crochets into the third. So one in the first, one in the second, and then two into the third. And now we're going to repeat that sequence all the way around until we land on our marker. Okay, so we're all finished round four, and we now have 24 stitches around. And you'll notice that it's not a perfect circle, but that's what you want. Round five is going to be one single crochet into the first three stitches, and then two single crochets into the fourth. And then repeat that sequence until we land on our marker. One in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and two single crochets into the fourth. And now repeat that sequence all the way around until you land on your marker. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row five. Okay, I'm at the end of row five, and we now have 30 stitches around. Rows 6 to 13 is going to be one single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for 8 rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here at the end of row 13. And remember to move your marker at the end of every row. Okay, so this is where we've stopped to put the eyes in, and right where our marker is where we're going to change colors. So we want to change colors away from the eyes, because even though we're going to use a method to try to clean up the color transition, there still is a bit of a transition. So we want that away from the eyes. And the first eye goes in between the 6th and 7th row from the magic circle. And this magic circle is right in the middle there where we started. And we're going to count the rings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we have our first eye goes in between the 6th and 7th row. And then we just pop the back on and push it together. And then the second eye goes between the 11th and 12th row, and we know this is the 7th, so 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So in between there. And you just want to make sure that your eyes are lining up, because once you put safety eyes together, they cannot come apart. So you want to make sure that you have them exactly where you want them. Okay, so now we're going to put the nose and mouth in now while we have a chance that the head is open. And the nose is just a couple of whip stitches, and the mouth is just an X shape. So I'm going to take a length of black yarn and my yarn needle, and I'm going to go in through the back, and I'm just going to wrap my yarn around this middle ring twice. So I'm going to come up through the back. I'm going to pull one of the yarn tails through and leave one of the yarn tails hanging in the back. So we're just going to go in and out. So there's the nose. And now for the mouth, we're going to put the X shape on there. We're going to go in through the back again. And we're just going to cross over to the top of the nose, top corner of the nose. So there's one half. We're going to go down and do the other side. And go to the other top corner of the nose and out through the inside of the head. And that's that. So now we just have to knot these two tails off in the back and then cut them a bit shorter. You don't want to leave black yarn tails inside a yellow head, because they will show through the stitches. So you just cut them up a bit shorter. So that should work. And there. Now we're ready to go do our color change. Okay, so now we're going to switch colors, and we're going to go into our next stitch and grab our yarn like we normally would. and leave those loops on our hook, and then hold our working yarn back here, and then bring in your black yarn and hold that back there as well. You're gonna have to change fingers here. And now we're gonna pull our black through these two yellow loops. And then we're gonna slip stitch into this next stitch. And how we do that is we just go in and grab our yarn like we normally would, and then pull that first loop through the second loop. So we didn't yarn over, we just pulled the loop through. And now we're gonna single crochet around, and I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. Okay, so I'm at the end of the row. I'm going to single crochet in that last stitch, and then I'm going to switch colors in the stitch after that. And we're not breaking free, we're just we're going to stay attached to both the black and the yellow yarn. And we're going to leave some nice lengths in here, because after we're all done, we're going to turn this piece inside out and cut those loops and knot them off. So we need some good lengths inside. So when I make a color change, I just kind of loop it down like this. Okay, so we bring in our yellow. Then I'm going to slip stitch the one after that. And then single crochet around and meet back here at the end of the row. Okay, so I'm at the end of the row. I'm going to single crochet in that last black stitch, and then we're going to change colors in the next one. Slip stitch the next one and single crochet around and meet back here at the end of the row. Okay, I'm at the end of the row. We're going to single crochet in the last stitch and then change colors in the next one. Bring up our yellow, and remember to leave loops on the inside that with enough length in them that we can work with later to tie those off. And then slip stitch the next one. And then single crochet around and meet back at the end of the row. Okay, we're at the end of the row, and now we're going to single crochet in the last stitch and change colors in the next one. Slip stitch the next one and single crochet around and meet at the end of the row. Okay, I'm at the end of the row, and we're going to single crochet in that last stitch and then change colors in the one after that. And slip stitch the next one and single crochet around and meet at the end of the row. Okay, I'm at the end of the row, and we're going to single crochet in that last stitch, and we're going to change colors in the next one. And slip stitch the next one. Whoops. And now single crochet around and meet back at the end of the row. Okay, so I'm at the end of the row, and we're going to single crochet in the last stitch, and we're going to change colors in the next one. Slip stitch the next one, and then single crochet around and meet at the end of the row. Okay, we're about to change the black, and this is the last time we change colors. And we're gonna decrease the hole on this round. So we're gonna single crochet in the last stitch like we always did, and we're going to switch colors in the next stitch. slip stitch the next one. Now that slip stitch is actually considered the first stitch of our row, and the pattern calls for one single crochet in the next three stitches and then crochet two together. Now remember, that's our first stitch right there. So we're going to put one in the next one and one in the next one. So that was three. And now we're going to crochet two together. And how we do that is we go in and grab our yarn and leave that loop on your hook. Go in the next stitch, grab your yarn, and now you have three loops on your hook. Now you yarn over and pull the yarn through all three loops. And then we repeat that sequence, one single crochet in the next three stitches, and then crochet two together. So one single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now we crochet two together. Go in and grab your yarn, leave that loop on your hook, go in the next stitch, grab your yarn, now you have three loops on your hook, now you yarn over and pull through all three loops. And repeat that again, one, 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 and two together. And we're going to repeat that all the way to the end. Okay, so I'm about to put my last set of the sequence in. So one single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and two together. And now we're going to pull this loop and leave it hanging. And we're going to turn the piece inside out. And this is where we're going to break free from the yellow yarn and also knot off all our color changes inside. Okay, first of all, we can break free from our yellow yarn. And here we're going to make sure that we're not cutting our working yarn or that loop we just pulled, our stitch. So there it is there. So you want to make sure you don't cut through those. So here's my color changes right here. And I have a fairly good length on them, so I can just hold them all and cut. Now I'm going to knot off each color change. And I should add, make sure you're knotting off each set, because when you knot them off, you kind of are pulling the spot of color change, you're going to be pulling it a little bit tighter. So it's going to straighten out those rows a little bit. So you want to knot off the right ones, and they'll be right beside each other. So, okay, so I got them all knotted off, and I cut them up a bit shorter. And I'm going to turn it right side. And this is where we're also going to stuff the front end of the doll. You see, by knotting it off, we actually straightened out those rows quite a bit. So on camera, there you can see a funky line here, but in person, when I'm looking at it, without looking through the camera, I don't see that funky line. So all I see is straight rows. So I'm not sure why it shows up on the camera like that. Okay, so now let's stuff the front end of the doll. So now I'm going to add my marker. So row 23 is going to be one single crochet in the next two stitches and then crochet two together. Okay, we're going to put one single crochet in the first stitch, one single crochet in the second, and then crochet two together. And now repeat that. One in the first, one in the second, and then crochet two together. And repeat that all the way around until you land on your marker. Okay, I made it around and I've moved my marker. And this row is going to be one single crochet in the next stitch and then two together. And repeat that until you reach your marker. So one in the first, and then crochet two together. Okay, I've made it around and I've just finished off my sequence, and I actually have an extra stitch. So somewhere along the line, I have picked up an extra stitch, and I don't know how I did that. So if that's happened to you and you've actually got an extra stitch in here, don't worry about it. One extra stitch isn't going to make or break the doll. So what we're going to do now is we don't need a marker anymore. We can put a little more stuffing in here. Now we want to get stuffing up in this area too. Okay, so I've stopped and I've stuffed the doll and I've pushed with my fingers up in this area here. So it's nice and full of stuffing. And now we're going to make the stinger part. And how we do that is we're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches and then crochet two together. And we're going to keep going and going and going. And eventually you're going to have a point. And as we go along here, and like I said, we don't need a stitch marker anymore. And just hold, try to hold the stuffing down with your fingers so you don't pull the stuffing through black yarn. It does not look very good, so try to hold that stuffing out of the way as you go along. It's one in the first, one in the second, and then crochet two together. We're just going to keep repeating that sequence around and around and around. And we are going to stop here too and put more stuffing in as we need to. And it'll be a good time to have a stuffing stick. If you don't have a stuffing stick, a chopstick will do. And also the back end of a pencil works great too. So when this hole gets a little bit smaller, we're going to stop and put a little bit more stuffing in there. Okay, so I'm going to use my stuffing stick. And I'm just going to stuff it down there. And use your stuffing stick to push the stuffing in the areas that you think needs it. Okay, so I'm going to continue around. I could actually stop right now, because that's a pretty good size stinger there. I'll just crochet two more together here. Close that hole up. And you can also slip stitch across. And on pieces like this, you don't want to just cut this off because it'll eventually unravel and then you'll get a hole in your stuffy. So we're going to take our yarn needle and then we're going to bring that yarn tail right down into the body. And then we can pull on it slightly and snip. And the yarn tail is hidden and it won't unravel. Okay, I went ahead and I made the ears. And the ears are a magic circle with four stitches in it. And then you put two single crochets in every one of those four stitches. And then you'll have eight stitches. And then you put one single crochet in every one of those eight stitches for six rows. And then you slip stitch and finish off. And when you do finish off, leave a long tail for sewing, because you're going to use that tail to sew the ears onto the doll. And I just cut a piece of white felt and I hot glued it into place. And what I do is I leave a row between the bottom edge of the felt and the bottom edge of the ear. I do that because for one reason it looks cute, and the other reason is you will not be able to sew through hot glue. It just won't work. So you need to have this edge open down here. So now we're going to sew the ears into place. And I'm just showing you here. I have the corner of this ear in line with the eye. So we know it's going to lay on that sixth ring there. Just get my first stitch in again. Okay, and again, I'm just going to bring it down. It doesn't really matter where you bring it, wherever makes you feel comfortable. Okay, that looks better. And now I'm going to go back in the same hole I just came out of. Go back up. And again, back in the same hole I just came out of. And I'm going up inside the ear, and I'm catching the bottom row. And I'm going to do the same thing for this side here. Back in. Well, I can't reach under there, so I'm just going to bring this up somewhere in the front where I know I can work it better. There we go. Well, that's pretty good. So I know that at the side stitches I wasn't stitching there, so I'm just going to put those in and then I'll be done with this first ear. Okay, one ear is done. So I'm just going to leave this tail here hanging and I'm just going to start my other ear and I'll show you why I do that. So I know my ear is going to go right beside that one, so that won't be any problems getting that one started. There. So I can do the same thing with this ear. And I brought this first tail down here, so when I'm done sewing the second ear in, I'll bring the tail out through here, I'll knot them off, and then I'll carry those two tails back in the body, pull on them, and snip them off. And then that hides the yarn tails inside the body. Okay, now we're going to make the wings. This is a good piece to bury your starting tail, because the wings is just one single piece, and you want to get rid of that starting tail that would be hanging right here. So we're going to crochet it into our piece as we go along. And we start off a magic circle with 6 stitches in it. And we're going to put 3 single crochets in the first stitch. So 3 single crochets is the same as 2, except for you put 3. So we're just going to hold that starting tail along the edge. And put our first single crochet. Going back in the same hole we were just in. And there's 2 single crochets. And back in the same hole we were just in, there's 3. Now we put a single crochet in the next 2 stitches. And now we put 3 single crochets in the stitch after that. So there's 1. Back in the same hole. There's 2. And back in, there's 3. And now we're going to put 1 single crochet in the last 2 stitches. There's 1. And the next, there's 2. So that starting tail is gone. And now we have 10 stitches around. In row 3, we're going to put 3 single crochets in the first 3 stitches. And we're not going to finish off this row. By that, I mean we're not going to use every single one of these stitches in the row. We're going to finish off before it's done. So 3 single crochets in the first 3 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3. And now into the next stitch. 1, 2, 3. And now again in the next one, 1, 2, and 3. and we're going to put one single crochet in the next four stitches, and then we're going to slip stitch and finish off. There's one, two, three, four, and now we slip stitch, and we're going to finish off, and we're going to leave a tail for sewing. So there is our wing. So what we're going to do now is we're going to sew the bottom of these wings together. So they will look like that. So there the wings are sewn together. And I'm going to put it, the bottom's going to be on those two rows there. So I'm going to leave these rows in between. So take your yarn needle and just go right down through the body. And while we're at it, we're going to put this other one, this other yarn tail, right down through the body as well to get it out of the way. And go right down through the body and out where the other one's coming out. Okay, so we can just start going back and forth up through the body and just go through the same hole you came out of. So I'm just going in and back up through the bottom edge of the wing on both sides, just to make sure it's securely in place. So that looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. So now I can take these two tails, and because they're both coming out the same hole there, I can knot these off. And thread the other one. And I'm going to carry these both. Pull slightly and snip, and the yarn tail is disappeared.